everybody. Welcome to Wapsie Valley High School. Thank you so much for coming out to see our production of The Addams Family. My name is Abby Fife. I'm the choir director here as well as one of the musical directors. Kim is somewhere. She is my co-director. That might be her now. Yes, Kim! So Kim and I have been working on putting this show together with the kids since January. They've worked so hard. We're so excited for you to see what they have put together. A couple other people I wanted to shout out before we get started. First, our wonderful folks in the booth. Jack Forsyth is an eighth grader at Wapsie Valley, and this is his second show helping us with lights. So please give a big round of applause to Jack. Also in the booth is Miss Emily Redden. She is our band director here, and normally I would do sound for the show, but I didn't know if I would be here this weekend because I am due on Tuesday. And so I decided probably shouldn't risk that, and I trained her up, and not that she needed training because she knows what to do by herself. But thank you so much, Emily, for helping with that. It's been a godsend to me. So round of applause for Emily. And then also in the house tonight is we hired a choreographer this year also because I would be in my third trimester of pregnancy, and normally I teach dancing. And I said, nope, not doing that this year. So Amy Wolf is in the house. Please give a wave, Amy. Welcome, Amy. The kids' dancing has been elevated to a whole new level this year, so you are sure to enjoy that. The last little thing that I want to say before we get started is it is going to probably get hotter and hotter as we sit in here this evening. We do not have air conditioning in this room. So just be aware of that. We do want to keep these blinds closed because it gets really bright in here. So if we need to open a window, that's fine. Just please keep the shades down for us. That'd be awesome. If you need to take a breather, that back hallway will be probably 10 degrees cooler than this room. So with that, please enjoy The Addams Family. Emily will be giving some pre-show announcements, and then we'll get started. So enjoy the show.
And welcome to the Wapsie Valley production of The Addams Family. I'm a fellow ancestor speaking from beyond the grave. I'm so happy to be here to give you this pre-show announcement, but also sad I'm deceased. Happy sad. Oh, well, that's besides the point. Before we shut off the house lights and move towards the darkness, we want to give you two, three, or maybe even four things to remember. First, make sure you turn those phones off. On this one normal night in Central Park, with the moon shining bright outside, we'll be showing what being in the Addams Family is all about. They may be crazier than you and me, but when you're in Addams, you're supposed to only like dark, bleak, spooky atmospheres. You may ask yourself, what if I don't turn off my phone? What'll happen? Well, any distracting lights or beeps from phones may result in Gomez coming from just around the corner and you being pulled to see his collections of instruments of persuasion. Please keep all items out of the aisles, including suitcases for running away, spiders, and a pillow and blanket for sleeping in the shed. If you need to exit for any reason during an act, please wait till after his song and scene is done. Then exit as quietly as the Addams Family crypt out the back doors. Full disclosure, there will be a 15-minute intermission. We sure don't want you feeling trapped in this auditorium the entire time. As you're waiting, you'll have the opportunity to use the little boy or girl's room, get a drink out of the Sacred Family water fountain, and stretch those legs. Make sure you focus and pay attention the entire show. We have lots of secrets and surprises in this production. Let's live before we die and not miss a moment of this incredible production. This is a musical comedy, so make sure to show your laughter. In fact, it's heavily encouraged. Also, please be sure to show lots of applause and love, especially for these seniors and Mrs. Fife, as it's their last show with us. Let's not talk about anything else but love for all these wonderful performers. Oh, it's time for me to tango on out of here. The Addams Family's eldest daughter Wednesday is growing up and is the boss of me now. If I keep going, I may have to meet her and her crossbow, and I really don't want to do that, not today. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. suffocating smell of the graveyard. Once a year, we gather beneath our family tree to honor the great cycle of life and death. Come, every member of our clan, living, dead, and undecided. And let us celebrate what it is to be an adult. Come to me, my luscious wife, for she has skin so pale, eyes so black, dress cut down to Venezuela. Tell us what it is that every adult hopes for.
Darkness, grief, and unspeakable sorrow.
I love it when you talk sexy. When you're an adult, you need to have a good life. When you're an adult, you need to feel so still. You have to see the world in shades of gray. You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way.
When you're an adult, you need to have a sense of humor. When you're an adult, be as besotted with each other as the night we met.
Our first date, you took me to see.
Death of a salesman.
How we laughed.
When you're an adult, you gotta have a lot of passion.
When you're an adult,
you need to really love your wife.
At least once a day.
You're happy when your toes are in the mud.
Beloved ancestors, why do we do this?
Because living or dead, family is still family.
Yes, and how do we do this?
By dancing on their graves.
Yes, Grandma Fester, dance! Time to wake the dead!
Death rattle.
ancestors. Now back to your crypt.
That's right, we have a problem.
His name is Lucas. Lucas Beinecke, and I'm in love.
That's right, little Wednesday Adams, that charming, irresistible bundle of malice who would poison her own brother just for a ride in the ambulance, has grown up and found love.
Oh, Wednesday, I just want to lock you up in a little white cottage with a picket fence and an apple tree.
I like the part about being locked up.
So here's the deal. Gather round. I'm not letting you all back into that crypt until love triumphs. So who is this Lucas fella? Is he worthy of her? Do they really love each other? What is love? Anyway, does this rash look serious to you? There's so many questions about love, but when you think about it, is there anything more important? Let's not talk about anything else but love. Aww. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals?
Okay, I won't tell your mother you're getting married.
Oh, thank you, Dad. our little secret, right?
Yes, yes, our little secret? Wednesday's growing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's growing up, as time slips by. When did she become someone else's chum? Someone else to make her father wonder why, oh why? Wednesday's growing up, she'll be Thursday before you know it. A puzzling thing, a secret in the house, a boy, a girl, a ring.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
She's in the kitchen smiling like this. Maybe it is this boy.
This boy, don't be silly. Ha, I say, and double ha. Ha, ha, you yourself said puppy love. Come, darling, I feel an urge to take you in my arms.
Gomez?
On the other hand, she is a healthy young woman, like you were. Are. Like you are. She could even fall in love and get married, like you did.
Don't be ridiculous. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
Of course.
And besides, she'll have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, but what if, and I have no particular reason to say this, but what if she did find someone who stole her heart?
Don't be silly. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
You do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh my, you're perspiring.
What?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar's shingles.
No, no.
I think Wednesday and I should have that chat.
Like a bull in the ring, like a moderate right wing, I'm trapped. Like a fly in my tea or the New York DMV, I'm trapped. With my wife to my left and my daughter to my right, any thought of my escaping must be scrapped. I could choose, sing the blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped, trapped, trapped. Like a boat in a rock or a cuckoo in a clock, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground or like Peter in the round, I'm trapped. I could cry, I could lie, I could simply have died, but I fear the dice I've rolled and find it cracked. Should I beg, should I rage, or stay safely in my cave? How? Trap, trap, trap. How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? The bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back for more. She stokes the atom's fire, she harbors its desire. I never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? Should I not be her hero instead of sniveling and weak? I'll take the route that's true, tell me what I must do. Should I write, should I groan, would I rather pass a stone? Crap. Wife gone wild, crazy child, little me unreconciled, I'm trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong, and we'll try to get along. Or I'll fail, have to bail, show my coffin to the nail. If I nap, if I snap, maybe dinner would be scrapped. Then I wouldn't be trapped. Trapped.
Thank you.
Ever since I met him, I want to laugh and cry, and everything seems right and wrong at the same time. And then sometimes, I just want to rip his flesh off and eat him up until there's nothing left. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in a position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been puzzled, and I think.
Dinner, and they can be back at their hotel by 9:30.
Wednesday, your father has something he has to tell you.
Actually, Paloma, your mother and I have had second thoughts.
What about?
This dinner, it all seems so quick.
It's not quick. Please, Dad, it's just a dinner, and they're dying to meet you, and I promised, Lucas, and you know how I hate to break a promise.
Yes, but your mother and I...
Dad, I'm your only daughter and your eldest child, and if you can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what.
Maybe just a little dinner.
Thank you, Dad.
Well, it seems I've been outvoted. The dinner it is. Drinks, dinner, and the game.
What? Please, no, not the game. But it's your family tradition. It's my dinner.
It's my house, darling. Dinner and the game.
One out of two, Paloma. Don't push it.
Fine. Then can we all at least act normal?
Define normal.
Squeak, squeak.
Normal is an illusion, darling. What's normal for the spider is calamity for the fly.
Mother, please. You're normal people, not like you, not like me.
And a pigeon dropped at my feet with an arrow in it. And I looked up, and there she was, Wednesday, with a crossbow.
A what?
A crossbow, you know?
This girl walks around with a crossbow?
It's okay, Dad. She has a permit.
Oh, dude. Good choice, son. Okay, listen up. Here's what's gonna happen. We're going back to the hotel, and you and I are gonna have a little talk.
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
See what you did? Your mother's rhyming again. Let's get back to the hotel.
No!
One normal night, no, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine. Tonight can't be absurd. Please don't embarrass me or be completely rude. Don't make a fuss about the house, about the food. Whoa, one normal night, I know it's big, but can't you see? This one normal night is for me. Come on.
Come on.
Seems like a nice young man.
Yeah. They're not right for each other.
What do you mean they're not right for each other? Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was nausea right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the sock vaccine? Are we ever gonna get this theater clean? Who's to say? One normal night is a perilous trick. Normal is hard to attain. Children are crazy and parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain.
remark. Hello, had a little trouble finding the place. Looks like somebody shot out all your street lamps. Wow, look at this place. They just move in or what?
No, this is how they live in New York. They spend all their money on rent and have nothing left for furniture.
Mel Beinecke. This is my wife, Alice. That's my son, Lucas. And you are? Nice talking to you. Earth to Alice, we've landed in Weird City. I say drinks and bye-bye.
Oh, now, be open to experience and welcome to the new. Reach deep into your surprise bag. There might be a gift for you.
Honey, my surprise bag is so full I can hardly lift it. The guy who patted me down at the airport, he slipped me his telephone number. I don't think I can stand any more surprises.
Come on, Dad, lighten up. They're your kind of people, real salt of the earth.
Oh yeah? Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, 1715, the Spanish warship Pico de Gallo, commanded by my great nautical ancestor, Captain General Don de Ventana Laguna, Don Jose Cuervo, leaves Madrid bound for the New World. 3 weeks later, he is still in Madrid is 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A stubborn man, he set sail anyway, only to sink 6 months later off the southern coast of Florida. A hostile land inhabited by rattlesnakes, mosquitoes, and many retired people. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume. And the lovely Mrs. Malcolm Beinecke. And you must be young Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father and you are the son with a massive thyroid problem. I go too far. No matter the night, she is young. Welcome to our extremely normal home. Gomez Florencia Adams, at your service. Allow me to present my wife, La Duena, the mother of my children, el amor de mi vida, the love of my life, Morticia. That's my little woman, a duchess in the parlor, and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez. So may I please, Mr. Beinecke?
Mrs. Adams.
Mrs. Beinecke.
Alice.
And you must be Lucas. What a lovely name.
Thanks. I'm named after my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods and ate his own leg.
You don't need to know that.
No. It's a beautiful story. Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his tongue. He off like this. Oh, how are you? Thank you, Mother. Hi, I'm Wednesday. What are you wearing? A dress. A yellow dress.
Paloma, what happened? You look like a crime scene.
Will you excuse us for a moment? I won't have that color in my house. I'm just being normal, okay? Darling, we don't wear bright colors. Bright colors are for people with no inner life and no imagination.
Oh, look, it's everywhere.
That is a beautiful dress, Wednesday. Yellow is the color of the
warming sun.
Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun. Why not show the world the love in which we all believe? Why not wear your heart for all to see right on your sleeve? Yellow is...
Excellent! A lovely sentiment about the color yellow. And now, why look everybody, it's Huxley Adam, Wednesday's younger brother, just returned from Bible study. Say hello, Puggles.
Hello. Can I make a donation?
Of course we are. What are we donating for?
Just, let's put money in the can. Nobody gets hurt.
Woo! Boys, ain't normal out here.
And this is our dear little grandma, the very soul and spirit of the family.
Hi, I just came from the hospital. Cardiac ward. Boy, are they dropping like moss over there. I trust you're staying in shape. Greens, fresh fruit, 30 minutes on the treadmill.
I know I should, but I don't do any of that.
Well, then, you're gonna die, honey! Are you ready for some football? Fester's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that kid go. He's on the 20. He's rounding third. And touchdown. The crowd goes wild.
This is my brother, Fester.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you, Fester. All right, now go away.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
And now for a welcoming toast from the extensive Adams Caves.
Children, you are excused. Lucas, come on. Dad, remember.
Not to worry, Paloma.
Leave the door open, you hear?
Ah, your concern? Not to worry, my friend. My daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. He tries anything, she'll rip his throat out. To the children.
Girls,
we used to, but we let them all go.
Come with me, dear. I'll show you.
Morticia, a grand tour for the missus. And the mister and I will go below for some guy stuff. And then, dinner!
And after dinner, the game.
Oh, yeah? What kind of game?
Did you ever play charades?
Yeah.
Well, it's nothing like that.
Did you get the flowers?
Oh yes, in the lovely poem. Wherever did you find it?
I wrote it.
No.
When I'm stressed or feeling blessed, a poem will simply get it off my chest. They come to me, they take no time. They just pop out, and they always rhyme.
Maybe you should see someone about that.
And they're always about the one thing everyone needs, and so few have.
Healthcare?
And my love, of course.
They're gonna freak when we tell them.
My father won't.
Why not?
Because I already told him.
What? You told your father with the sword, that we're getting married, just like that.
He's totally cool with it, mostly.
I thought we said we were gonna tell him all together.
We need his help. You don't know my mother. She could really screw it up.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. Look, it might seem old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You're right. It is old-fashioned.
Lucas, do you love me?
Of course.
Then leave it to me. It's all going according to the plan.
What plan? There is no plan!
That's the plan. Improvise. Keep them guessing.
You're so crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's just a simple dinner. What could go wrong? Come on. Aww. Be patient, and soon the way will be clear. Your fear and troubles all will disappear. Let's not talk about anything old.
Please don't leave us out in the cold.
Let's not talk about anything else but love.
But love.
But love.
Interesting chair. Antique?
15th century, the heretic's chair. Once owned by Tomas de Torquemada, Grand Inquisitor of Madrid.
You collect this stuff?
And man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, some play golf. Me, I collect instruments of persuasion. Go on, ask. Ask.
Why?
Because it's fun. The history of the world told in agony and dismemberment. Get up, I show you. You sit, they ask you a question, they don't like the answer. Ooh, that don't make you believe, eh? Sit down, I ask you a question.
Some other time.
Okie dokie. So, how about these crazy kids, eh?
What about them?
They seem very fond of each other, no?
I guess, but it's not like they're getting married.
Married? What? No, of course not. They're so young, of course. They do get married young these days, do they not?
I don't know what they do.
Then talk about you. The Beinecke Saga. Your lives, your hopes, your dreams, your son.
Lucas? He's a little soft like his mother, but when he gets out of college, I'll toughen him up, teach him the business, and make him a man.
May I say something? You and I feel we understand each other. Do you feel this?
No. So tell me, Adams, 10,000 square feet right in the middle of a public park, how do you swing this place?
These 2 acres have been in my family ever since Queen Isabel of Spain deeded it to my great ancestor, Alfonso the Enormous. Come by the key, I show you the moat. Did you bring a bathing suit? Never mind, let's be crazy.
Secrets, there's a world of things. me.
She kept a secret and they shot her with an M16.
That's not a pretty scene.
She kept a secret and she wound up on the cover of a magazine. She's quite the Philistine.
What's that one?
The dance routine.
At the bookstore, and on weekends I tutor kids at a charter school, and summers I work at my uncle's grocery store.
Is any of these true?
Most of it.
Wise guy.
Mostly, I think about Wednesday and how much I love her, and how we can have a wonderful life together.
And what does a Lucas Beinecke become when it grows up?
Maybe a writer or a medical examiner.
A medical examiner? Why?
You get to look at the inside of people's bodies and they don't care because they're dead.
Where did you find him?
We found each other. It's kind of a miracle.
Thomas!
Oh no.
What are we gonna do?
Let's just tell her. It's going to be fine.
You promised after dinner.
What are the three of you whispering about?
The news!
The economy!
The economy.
Weather!
The news!
Well, we're gonna go now. See you at dinner.
Come, Lucas. I show you the moat. Did you ever see a rat as big as a dachshund?
No, sir.
Gomez, what's going on?
Nothing. We were just talking.
That wasn't talking. That was conspiring.
No, it was talking. Conspiring is...
That's what you were doing!
Querida, stop these foolishness.
You're keeping something from me?
Querida, I have never kept anything from you, and may lightning strike me where I stand if I am keeping anything from you now.
That it should come to this.
Here, Carla, I feel an urge to take you in my arms.
Not today.
What?
Not today, and I'll be in my room waiting for you to share, like a proper husband.
Morticia, Mia! Like a bug in a jar or a frozen cable car, I'm trapped. Like a man growing gray when his wife says not today. What if she doesn't dance with me anymore? Who could conceive it? What if I and one tiny lie started civil war? What if the line being crossed, vows of commitment lost? How is that possible? Could it be possible?
Yo, it's the Pogster. What up, little man?
Trying to be cool.
Yep.
Because you're not cool?
Your sister thinks I am.
Yeah, she'll get over it.
Aren't you rather too young to be drinking coffee?
I'm under a lot of stress, okay? My sister is having an identity crisis.
We're gonna go now.
Wait. Can I go?
Sorry, Pugs. I'm with Lucas now. Bye.
Wait! What if she doesn't torture me? Then how would I manage? What if she doesn't nail my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me a-okay, hiding each power tool? Why would she be so cruel?
Chimichanga, a man hated by the French but clever with a quip. In fact, while being burned alive, he said to the priest, "Keep it pink in the middle, a little crispy on the outside."
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Please, not the game. It's really late.
But it's a family tradition.
Pugsley, could you just go away and die?
I will if your boyfriend will.
Tara. Maybe the game's a bad idea.
Thank you, Dad.
Nope, it's a good idea. And if it isn't, then somebody will be sleeping on the couch for a very, very long time.
Actually, the game is a good idea. The best of all ideas.
What kind of game?
We call it Obligación de Revelar.
Oh, Spanish?
What does it mean?
Full disclosure.
Exactly. Everybody sips from the sacred family chalice.
And confesses a secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you have to absolutely tell the truth.
Or what?
Or there are consequences.
I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
Sure you would.
Oh, no, 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 no. No.
And now it's time to play. Gomez, break the ice. My husband has something he needs to disclose.
Actually, the host goes last.
Lurch the sacred chalice.
This is a sacred chalice from Adam's family's past. Burn my digitalis, held fast, die cast. Here in the sweet libation, salvation resides. Feel the sweet sensation, revelation provide. Full disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darkest secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, I'm playing full disclosure with all these crazy happy people.
Full disclosure,
it's a heck of a thing. What's a favorite of the late thing coming? Doesn't matter if you're right or left wing, he loved his full disclosure.
Yes, well, my disclosure is in the form of a fairy tale. Once there was a man who had a beautiful wife and two beautiful children. A humble man, I say, and yet within his breast beat the heart of a loyal and steadfast husband who treasured his wife and worshipped the ground she walked on. Thank you. And one day, a fox appeared and gave him a beautiful box of rare wood and Spanish leather. What's in the box, asked the kindly man. And the fox said, a little secret, nothing important, but you must never open it. And the kindly man took it home and his beautiful wife said, let's open it anyway. And the kindly man said, honey, we've got a good thing going. Don't push it. And they never did open it. And they all lived happily ever after. Full disclosure.
Well, I guess we'll just have to come back to you, won't we? Wednesday's turn.
Pass.
Yes, let's hear from Bester, the chalice.
I am in love.
Aww.
You're probably thinking, what could a fat, bald person with absolutely no love life know about love? But I, too, am in love. Bester loves.
Oh, Bester, who is it?
The moon.
The moon. He's in love with the moon.
Yeah, that's
cool. That is the most beautiful thing I've ever heard.
Oh, I haven't told her yet.
Aww.
Full disclosure.
Full disclosure,
just embrace it and swoon.
Embrace and swoon.
Grace and fall in love with the moon.
He loves that moon.
Close your sermon with a signature tune.
And call it full disclosure.
When
much problem.
Wednesday, your turn. The chalice. Where's the chalice?
Now, with a dash of potion, my sister blows her cool. Hopefully, in slow motion, she'll drop, she'll drool. One sip of acrimonium, and then she will change. Boy, oh boy, her full disclosure's gonna be strange.
Full disclosure,
it's the moment of truth.
La 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 la.
Now you better hit the truth like Babe Ruth.
La 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 la.
This is torture like an impacted tooth. Hooray for full.
No!
My wife isn't herself, so we'll be on our way.
No! We are in the middle of a game, so bite your lip and sit right down.
Alice, I think you've had enough to...
Remember how it used to be, Mal? The way we used to look at each other. The way we used to leave the restaurant in the middle of dinner to rush home and go upstairs. Sometimes you just couldn't wait. So you'd pull that car over to the side of the...
Mom!
Light up, Lucas! Parents do it! Live with it! Remember, Mal, when we were crazy and the future didn't exist? Whatever happened, Mal? The guy with the Grateful Dead t-shirt. Is he ever coming back? How long do I have to wait?
Woman waits for marriage. Woman waits for children. She waits for her big mouth to come back home. At 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock.
Secrets come.
Yes, we kept a secret. Can you get me?
Play it once and life is never the same. Someone started it, so someone's to blame. Enough of fools.
Stop! Never fails. You let nature take its course. Chaos. I mean, is this any way to end an act? Actually, yeah. But it'd be better if the guests couldn't leave just yet, don't you think? Okay, dead people, give me some weather.
It's a tornado. We'll never make it out of the park alive.
Well, Bionicles, looks like you'll be spending the night. That's what happens when you play
Full Disclosure.
Is just around the corner. Waiting.
they got to you. That doesn't even rhyme.
What's wrong with that?
I did not raise my son to be kidnapped by a bunch of creeped out left-wing Spanish weirdos.
You didn't raise him, Mal. I did. You were at the office, remember?
I was at the office for you, for him. I had plans for the boy.
Oh, Mal, he's in love. Let him follow his heart.
Follow his heart? That's crazy.
Crazy? What's wrong with crazy? Crazy's underrated.
Let me get this straight. Your son, your only son, wants to marry someone who is named after a day of the week and runs around Central Park with a crossbow, and you're okay with all that?
If it makes him happy, yes.
Well, you better come to your senses, or I'm gonna have to take steps.
Good idea. Why don't you start by taking steps outside?
What?
If you're going to act like a tool, you can go sleep in the shed. Mom!
What?
Oh, nothing. Ladies, hello? Yoo-hoo!
you think you're going, young lady?
Away.
Elopement?
Dad, would you please just let me?
No! This is what comes from keeping secrets. If the two of you wanted to get married, you should have just—
There's not going to be any marriage.
No? Why?
He bailed.
What? A breach of promise? An outrage.
He thought running away was a bad idea.
On the other hand, he does have a point.
I hate him!
Well, it's a beginning, something to build on.
He says he can't live without me, and then he lets me go. I love him. Why does he love me?
You just said you hated him. Which is it?
Both.
Now you've got it. Right and wrong, who's to say which we should refuse? All we know, love survives either way we choose. Here you are at the edge, go ahead and fall. Don't resist, I insist. Even conquered you, my adorable little Dilla. You had to go and grow up, huh?
And you're cool with that?
Yes. Oh. I'm feeling happy. I'm feeling sad. A little childish. A little dad. I think of all the days you know. All the ways you grow, see you on your own and bled. I'm feeling happy and sad again. I think I'm rested, but then I'm tired. Today requested, tomorrow fired. And now a boy says he adores. She who once was yours. How can I ignore such news? I'm sad and happy. Why should I choose? I hate you.
In every heaven, you'll find some hell. And there's a welcome in each farewell. Life can be harsh, the future strict. Who could dare greet it? And the boy you picked, not bad. Let's be happy, forever happy, completely happy, and a tiny bit sad.
You should be a writer. Have you met my daughter? This is Wednesday, the best thing that will ever happen to you. Don't screw it up.
Yes?
Look, I can't stand the idea of not being with you.
5 minutes ago you could.
Yeah, but see, the lover always comes back. Ulysses, Tristan, Romeo.
Listen, I'm homeschooled. What's your point?
I'd rather die than live without you.
Okay, prove it.
What?
Prove it.
What are you?
Here, put this apple on your head and go stand by the tree.
Wait, you're gonna... You're crazy.
And you're not crazy enough. That's the problem.
I guess I got stuck, Alice. more than most men. But Mama, I swear, I'll be crazy again.
Mal, you're rhyming.
For you, baby. Just for you.
I learned from Lucas. I learned from you. I wasn't happy. I wasn't true. But then the way you spoke at dinner touched my soul. Completely crazy and completely in control. So when you kicked me out, I said, let's rock and roll. So I'll be crazier than you, much crazier than you. It warms me up to see you living large. When I'm crazier than you, much crazier than you, I'll drop the plan, you'll be the man in charge.
My man, all I needed was the hope that you'd submit.
Too afraid and too conceited, believe that you were it. But the journey's now completed.
Oh, man, I miss you, pumpkin.
To you. You want to see the world? Done. You want sewers? I'll show you sewers fit for a queen. Where's that hotel guide? Ah, Hotel Merde, Rue de Toilette. Condemned 6 times by the Board of Health.
Not enough.
Voila, Hotel Nosferatu. Rating, -3 stars. No windows, no towels, no staff. Bingo! The worst hotel in Paris. Get them on the line. Hurry, this is the final round, my friend.
Did I ever once believe this day would come? Did I ever once expect the worst? Did I ever dream that I would feel this way? Dios mio, no, this is a first. I'm a Latin, men in Latin, men are smart. Everything we do is muy sincere. Leading with a sword as much as with a heart. Never once was I prepared to hear. Not today, she's better than my face. Not today, not even second base. Not today, the words I heard her say. Not today, not today, not today. I remember well the day she poisoned me. No one else I cared enough to try. How did she uncover all the joys in me? All the ways she promised I would die. Every year that passes, I desire her more. Anyone who knows us would agree. She's my angry fever, flu, and canker sore. She's my only hepatitis B. Not today, I'm dancing on my arm. Not today, a dog without a bone. Not today, the traffic runs late. Not today, not today, not today.
Is that my call to Paris?
It's about time.
Hello, Hotel Nosferatu. Listen, the future of my marriage is at stake.
Can you confirm this is the worst hotel in Paris? Because I need to get your foolish guarantee. What I would pay if you could say you turned my party déjeuner from an abandoned contemporary. I must be clear, don't want to circulate misnomers. You must have rodents in the bath at any cost. It says right here in my new guide I brought from Fromers that even in July the pipes are deep with frost.
Gomez! Gomez, Morticia's leaving!
What?
She's at the gate with the police! It's the end of the family!
Is this the moment where I turn a little gray? Is this the moment where my marriage vows decay? Is this the moment where Morticia runs away? No! Not today! Not today! Not today!
Another secret I haven't told you.
Huh? What?
That you are the most exquisite, the most magnificent, the most desirable of all women.
That's no secret.
But even you have a secret once.
Never.
And if you are wrong?
I never am.
But if you are, what will you give me?
Name it.
A dance?
Go on.
Many years ago, when you loved me and you wanted to marry me, we went to your father and told him, and he said, "Wonderful, let's go tell your mother." And what did you say?
How could I possibly remember what I...
You said, "No, she'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing."
That was different. My mother was condescending, judgmental, and withholding, and loved nothing more than stirring up trouble.
Uh-huh.
Oh, no. I've turned into my mother!
Wednesday is you! Isn't it wonderful?
You did that like a lawyer.
No, just a husband and a father. Not so easy. In fact, very difficult.
Let's live before we die. Let's laugh before we cry. Let's hold each other tight and dance. If I have caused you pain, it's easy to explain. Come fill me with delight and dance. My life, forever you will be. But when is life, that too is part of me. Two women I adore and sworn to suffer for. Let's end this tug of war and dance.
My mother told me to beware clever men with silver tongues.
What I lack in depth, I make up for in shallowness.
You really think you can sway me with a joke?
It's the last thing I try before the chloroform.
Tomorrow I may
darling, I was bad. Bad husband and bad dad, instead of being sad.
Alone we're lost, we're drifting out to sea.
But side by side, we're gloomy as can be. As gloomy as can be.
Morticia, I was wrong.
I knew it all along. Forgive me with a song.
And dance.
Mi amor, creature of constant surprises. You have legs.
Changed our lives.
How can we ever thank you?
Tell your friends, word of mouth is so important. Young lady, step forward and speak the words that every mother longs to hear.
I'm sorry.
You really want to marry this boy?
I do.
Why?
He's willing to die for me. Mother, I need to ask you something.
Yes?
Go ahead. Just ask her.
Can we have your blessing?
Of course. And may you have many children, and may they give you as much grief as you've given us.
Attention, everybody. I have a full disclosure. I'm taking my beautiful wife to Paris.
Oh, Gomez, the sewers.
Special package, one day, seven nights.
Je t'aime, mon cher. Je t'aime, tes jours.
Ah, the French.
Okay, fun seekers. My acrimonia was missing, so I sniffed around. Tell me what happened, you little bed boy.
Ah, you're all so smart, you figure it out.
All right, let's see. You were afraid you'd lose your sister.
So you stole my acrimonium?
To make Wednesday and Lucas fall out of love with each other.
But I never got to drink it because...
I passed it to my mother.
And I drank it and became who I really am.
Which made me fall in love with my family all over again.
And I reached deep into my reservoir of womanly compassion and bathed your father in forgiveness.
Welcome to the family. We aren't losing a daughter. We're gaining three Beinekes. Young man, for purely selfish motives, you turned a simple dinner party into a nightmare.
And we couldn't be more proud.
Pugsley, you're an artist. You rearranged life itself and it all came out even. You're the best brother in the world.
So you're still gonna torture me?
Of course, until you get a girl of your own.
My son, you embrace the darkness of your despair, and suddenly the world makes sense. You are a true Adam. Thank you.
at last.